Hey everyone, today we're going to learn how to make animated GIFs inside of PowerPoint and then bring those inside of Storyline or Articulate Rise to add a little bit more life to our graphics rather than just static graphics. So we'll talk about that today. Welcome back. My name is Jeff Batt, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Now here you can check out all previous blog posts covering everything on learning developments. You can see all XAPI, you can see Camtasia related, JavaScript and Articulate Storyline, all those different blog posts. You can also download templates, free templates, on Articulate Storyline 360, XAPI and video, how to track a PDF with XAPI as well. And if any of these topics are new to you, you can check out full courses, everything from A to Z in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 videos. Now, I've really been fascinated lately with how to bring to life your images inside of Articulate Storyline. Seeing some great examples of animated GIFs that go inside of even Rise and that really enhance the course as well. Now you can do this with both Storyline and Rise, and one of the simplest ways to create an animated GIF is actually within PowerPoint. Now PowerPoint, love it or hate it, that it can do a lot of different types of animations, which are great, and I'll talk a little bit about those. And some of them are extremely easy and add a lot of life to it. So one of the coolest ones is the morph animation inside of PowerPoint. So what I'm going to do, I have my PowerPoint and I just want to do a simple graph. And so I created some bars, I created some text, and I created just some line items here. So you can see, just to create that graph fill. And inside of Storyline, I don't have anything yet. I just have a blank page, but I wanted to show you why you can't actually do this type of thing, the animated bar. I want the actual graphs to go up and down. And this is the reason why you can't do it inside of Storyline, which I wish you could. But inside of Storyline, you do have transitions, but you don't have the morph transition that PowerPoint does. And you also, in animations, you do have like fly in or grow or fade or wipe. But here's the problem, is I want those to like stay the same at the bottom and grow at the top. So in this case, it's gonna grow the entire thing. It's not gonna adjust it manually there. So this is one of the reasons why I can't use Storyline for this type of effect. And I could use the animated GIF in order to accomplish this type of effect here. So just wanted to point that out just to make sure we're clear there. Now to do this inside of PowerPoint, it's pretty simple. So all I need to do is use the morph transition. All right, so to do this, all I have to do is right click and duplicate slide. To do a morph animation, it needs to have similar objects on the slide before in order for it to know what to morph or to animate to, which is pretty cool. And again, I wish Storyline had this type of effect here, but you can see that now I have two slides that are exactly the same. So what I need to do on slide number two is I need to make the adjustments of where I want it to end up. So I'm gonna go ahead and say, let's say Q4, we had a decrease in this number, we had an increase in this number, we had a decrease in that number, increase in this one. I'm not using real math here, so keep that in mind. I'm just adjusting some of the bars here. So I'm gonna go ahead and decrease that and then increase graph one there. So you can see that now, even though I'm using the same objects as slide one, I've changed the positions. Anytime you're working with animation, there's really a point A of where the object starts and a point B of where the object ends. Now that I've set point A in the previous slide and now I've set point B in this slide, PowerPoint can figure out what to do with it at this point. So what I need to do is come into the transitions here, because it's gonna go from transition the slide A to slide B, or slide one to slide two. And all I have to do is come into transitions and click on this morph transition. Now it will give me a little pop-up if this is the first time that I'm using this, just to kind of give me an idea of what's going to happen here. I'm gonna click on got it. And then now I'm gonna preview this or go into presentation mode here. Oh, forgot to actually apply morph. So I'm gonna click on apply morph here. And it will give me a little bit of a preview on how that is going to play out. So let's go back to slide one, hit slideshow here. And then now you can see how all of the numbers adjust. Great. So how do I put this as an animated GIF inside of Storyline or inside of Rise? Well, that's our next step here. So I'm gonna exit out of that and I'm gonna go to file And then I'm going to go to export here. And on export, all I have to do is select this drop-down box for the file format to animate a GIF. Now it's going to give me a couple different settings that I can adjust for this animated GIF. And the animated GIF is really gonna play my slides from start to finish here. So it's automatically going to adjust this. So the first thing I wanna do is make sure that this is extra large. I wanna get as much quality as I can. If your storyline file size or if your animated GIF becomes really large, you can try bumping that down a little bit. But if I can, I will try to get as much quality out of it as possible here. So right here, do I wanna make the background transparent? Which in this case I do, and I'll show you why when I bring it into storyline or rise. I'm gonna make this transparent here. And then seconds spent on each slide. So right now it's gonna spend 5 seconds on slide one, and then it will transition into slide two. I wanna make that a little bit quicker, so I'm gonna adjust that to two. Now, which slides do I want to export? I wanna export all of them at the moment, but if you only wanna export a few of them, you can just enter from what slide to what slide if your PowerPoint is very large here. I'm just gonna keep it as one, slide one to slide two. Now it's going to export at a 19 by 1080 frame ratio and 24 frames per second, which is fine. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on export, make sure that I know it's going to export to my desktop, and click on export from there. Now, if I hide PowerPoint now, and I come into this animated GIF or GIF, I've heard it both ways, you can see that as soon as I preview it, it will start to animate. So it starts, it's about 2 seconds before it starts to animate, and then it starts to animate. But notice how it starts to loop. By default, animated GIFs from PowerPoint are going to loop over and over. You may want that effect. If you do, great. But if you don't want that effect, the only way that I've found how to stop that is to go into a GIF editor. And that GIF editor, you can find free ones if you wanted to, but the one that most people probably have is Adobe Photoshop. So if I come and open this up inside of Adobe Photoshop, now you can even create GIFs inside of Photoshop. You don't have to do this in PowerPoint, but not everyone may know how to use Adobe Photoshop, so that's the reason why I spent most of it in PowerPoint here. But this is just a simple adjustment. All I have to do is open it up in Photoshop. So I'm gonna go into File, and then I'm gonna go into Export, and then we're gonna go to Save as Web Legacy. In the Save as Web Legacy, it's gonna pop open with a menu, and in that menu down here where it says Looping Options, it's set to Forever. We want to adjust that to be just once. We just want it to loop that one time. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on Done now, and now it is saved. Don't save it from here because it already is exported out, so I'm gonna just hit Cancel, and then I can hide Photoshop. Even though I've done that, and I hit Spacebar here on a Mac, it's gonna just keep looping over and over. The preview here loops over and over, but it will not loop over and over once I bring it into Storyline. So now let's go into Storyline. Let's click on Insert. Let's go into our picture here, and then I'm gonna go into my desktop right here, click on this graph, and double click on that graph. Now I forgot to get rid of that previous bar, so I'm gonna just get rid of that previous bar, and then I'm gonna bring that into here. All right, so it kind of fits perfect with the size of screen that I use for Storyline. So I'm gonna preview this now. So there is my animated graph. Took 2 seconds before the animation happened. Let me try that loop one more time. I'm gonna open this up inside of Photoshop here. Let's try to export that out. Let's make sure that I saved it in the right spot as well. I'm gonna name this one Graph 1. Yeah, I think I clicked done without actually saving it. So that's the problem. So let's bring this back in now. We're gonna bring in that graph one. There we go. So now let's preview this. 2 seconds here, it's going to animate, and then now it should stop because I stopped it there. Yep, and it did. So just make sure that you save it after you've adjusted it to that once inside of Photoshop. And if for some reason it's still looping, that means because something was skipped there. So keep that in mind. All right, so that is how you use PowerPoint to animate something and then bring it inside of Storyline. Now, if you can animate it inside of Storyline, stick with Storyline because the file size will be smaller. But if you're trying to get this type of effect that Storyline can't do, use something like PowerPoint, animate it in PowerPoint, save it as an animated GIF, and just create these lively animations that will bring it to life more. So I just wanted to show that as an example. If you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button, and make sure that you subscribe to my channel as well, and hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps grow my channel, allows me to keep producing these videos for you. And also, if you have any like suggestions of what other videos you want to see, make sure you go on and make a comment on my YouTube channel as well, and let me know what else you want to see. I'm happy to add that to my backlog and explore those different videos in the future. That's all I have for today though, so thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.